friends.
Hello, art friends.
Today we are going to be showing you some Posca pens.
Yes, these things.
And they come in such bright, colourful colours because they're actually paint markers. I'll show you them all in a second, actually, because there's too many to really hold up on camera.
Mm-hmm.
But we were thinking, what is better to draw with, like, bright, colourful colours than, like, tropical birds?
Yeah.
They seem quite trendy with, like, colouring books and stuff at the
trendy
moment.
Trendy bird.
These are, like, all the loose ones that we own.
Mm-hmm.
Then we've got this pack. These are more so like fine nibs. These are some massive ones that I bought for Adam recently.
This is a really nice present that you got me. The tips like, on these are enormous.
Look at how big these are compared to, let's find a fine liner. Yeah. Look at that size difference. Especially the nibs on them.
There
yeah.
you go.
The one on the right's like a tiny little fine liner, and then this one's got a huge chiseled tip. And another little cool addition that Adam's just recently picked up, that he's kind of sitting on. Careful. We live near some antique shops, and they had in these little booklets that Adam found. And this one's got like a bunch of tropical birds in. It sounds like back in the day, this was long before we were born. There used to be some with cigarettes, but I don't think this one was with cigarettes.
I think these were tea bags, and you could collect the little card things, which are these. And
we've been very lucky with this one because this person seems to have collected like every tropical bird. And look at the little inked illustrations that they have as well. We do have like another one that we once found where you had to collect them off like packets of cigarettes.
Yes, you had like a chain smoker's book.
We've also got one of like English birds. But the person who had this one hadn't completed it. So
yeah, there's only a couple missing.
But yeah, I like really like drawing birds. They're one of my favourite things to draw. There's one missing.
That's a swan. A whooper swan.
Whooper swan.
I mean, the reason that we got these as well is because I did go out shopping to get some food, and I seen these and I spent our food money on these, so we don't have a lot of food. You took it really well.
It's like... I didn't mind. I think they're cool. Plus it's inspired a doodle day, so kudos to Adam.
And if we get hungry, we can eat these.
Do you guys like drawing birds, or is this just like an obscure thing that we have?
I'm excited to get going. I think maybe what we should do is, how about if you choose one book?
No, we're drawing tropical birds.
Oh, but does that mean these guys don't get no love? Well, we can always draw these birds later.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Expect a video in the future called, like, drawing English birds.
In England. How many tropical birds can you name?
Parrot. Cockatiel.
Mm-hmm.
Whooper swan.
He's English.
You were showing me a video of this guy earlier on. Like, what's his name?
He needs some slippers.
Here's your pencils.
Ooh. Oh, has anyone ever heard of these shoe bells? Because a lot of people say they look like loft wings from Skyward Sword, these guys. I think they're called shoe bells in real life.
Is it because it looks like you could use them to get your shoe off?
Just grab his head, take my shoe off. Okay, I think we should get started. Are you sniffing it?
The book smells so antique-y.
Yeah, there's like a certain smell.
Like, books always smell nice when they're new, but old books, guys, do any of you guys collect like old books? Because they have like a specific...
It's probably like mold.
It smells kind of perfumey.
It does not smell like perfume.
It does. It smells like a grandma's kept it for a long time.
It does. It smells like old people in book form.
Nice. Does anyone else like smelling their grandma?
Yeah. I'm so glad you came to visit.
Oh, I used to love sniffing my grandma.
Don't tell people that.
Oh, okay. I won't tell anyone.
Have you picked a bird yet?
No. Which one do you want to draw? We might as well, like, on every page or something, we'll pick one.
How about we pick one for the other person to do?
Okay, who are you picking for me to draw?
I think you should do the macaw.
Okay.
Who do you want me to do?
That one, the ornate umbrella bird.
Oh, no. It looks like he's got a slug on his head.
I probably look like a French beret. I like how we've got all these beautiful coloured Posca pens. I've picked you, like, a very black-looking bird.
I'll make it work.
I'm jumping straight in. We're trying to draw a parrot.
We need David Attenborough to narrate. It's like, and here we see Steph trying to draw the macaw.
Trying.
And the macaw looks sad because he doesn't have any eyes.
That's a good reason to be sad. At least he can't cry about it,
yeah.
Though. It doesn't look anything like a parrot yet.
It looks like a parrot wearing a bed sheet, like a ghost parrot. It's like, oh.
Oh, he's looking more like Voldemort.
Voldemort didn't even have a nose. Look at all that big pecker he's got.
How's your ornate umbrella bird going?
The bird that is just made up of random words. I really liked your idea of him having a beret, so I might just put that little, the little point in. Doesn't that look like one of those really frilly Victorian t-shirt? Well, not a t-shirt, but the ruffly things.
Yeah,
there.
Like when posh people stay out for dinner, like, and they tuck it all in. Yeah. Yeah.
It looks like he's got his ruffles out.
He's like a Shakespeare bird. My parrot's just looking a bit too intense at the moment.
Polly want counselling?
I used to have a pet parrot.
Did you? Oh yeah, you did. What was its name?
Tika.
Tika parrot, yeah. I never met Tika, but if she looked anything like that, I'm glad it didn't. I'd love to see one in real life. Like, does this thing like flop around in the wind? Like his little
tassel-y bits. Like a cape.
Does like his bowl cut get in his eyes? It's such an interesting bird.
Adam kept teasing my bird, so I made him look happier. I'm going to start colouring my bird.
I'm not sure how to colour mine, because he's very dark.
Wow, are you going in with your big chunky ones?
Well, the only light blue that we've got is this really big one, so I might have to be...
No, I think we've got one in this, haven't we? Yeah.
Yes! Thank you.
Do you guys have any suggestions for what his name should be?
What about Jean-Luc? That's a really cool name. I wish my name was that.
It's fun using Posca pens again, because like in our very first art video, I was using Posca pens in it.
Was you? I can't even remember.
At the library, can't you remember? I was drawing birds, actually. Aww. Posca pens work really nicely if you're doing like a painting, and you can obviously get a paint effect with a pen if you want to put some tiny little details in, but you're scared to go in with a brush. I might have to use a pencil to shade the beacon because we don't have a grey.
Oh, yeah, that'd work.
Yay, you're colouring your beautiful tropical bird.
Oh, it looks very dark.
Yeah, I might as well have picked out like a crow. Yeah.
It's just a really fashionable looking crow. Mine's going to be like a band of birds and he's the lead singer.
I wonder if that's actually a thing.
What, a real bird band?
No, I mean like a group that's called Bird of Bands.
Band of Birds.
Oh, dang it.
And the hit single's Birds of a Feather.
That's so lame. Squawk cover.
Don't make fun of Jean-Luc's vision.
He looks like he'd study fine art at university.
He did. He took fine art and psychology.
And psychology.
To help your parrot.
He also looks like he appreciates a good loaf of bread.
He does, and he likes lattes.
Lattes.
Right, I'm going to let that dry for a second and put some good blue idea. In.
It's not fair, I gave you the most colourful bird.
I know, right? Ah, but you're colourblind, maybe I was doing you a favour.
Let's not trick ourselves.
I was looking out for you. I've got so many like rolled up paint flecks that I want to remove, but I know it'll rub paint everywhere so I'm putting it off.
You picked me like the hardest bird in the world to colour.
It's coming along so well. And obviously because these are paints, you can overlay like lighter colours.
Yeah, as long as you let it dry, you can go over it pretty much as you want, really. I can't even remember your name.
He's Jean-Claude.
Oh,
how could you forget?
I don't recognise him with this horrible colour job that I've given him.
Yay. This might help him look a bit more parity now he's got a grey beak. Yes! One of my favourite things about Posca pens is just how vibrant they are.
Yeah.
If you work with like, I don't know, alcohol markers and stuff, it's kind of hard to get the punch that something like this has. I reckon we should pick another bird.
Yeah, all I've got left is to do his little beret, so do you want me to pick a page next?
Yeah, probably best my hands have got a bit painty while I was removing the paint flecks off this.
Okay, I know what bird I'm going to ask you.
Which one?
I want you to paint the Scarlet Cock of the Rock.
Oh, that one. Oh, isn't he on the front cover of the book?
Yeah, there he is. He's not on a rock, he's on a branch. You need to pick one for me.
Oh, gladly. Let's see. Oh, the rest of them are all cute.
I know, that's why I picked you that one.
I think you should go with this one because he's got a massive beak.
Whoa. What's he called?
He looks like a flamingo, but he's a fake. You know, having a bird around like that would be so handy when we clog the Hoover.
You'd jam its beak down the Hoover. Yeah.
I hope you guys can appreciate how wonderful my sketch is looking right now. Apparently, English robins look totally different to American robins.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. What do the American ones look like?
I think the English ones are like smaller, rounder, and a bit chubbier.
Yeah, they're quite fat, the English ones are.
So one of my friends moved to England and she was just like, oh my gosh, robins look like they do on Christmas cards.
Of course they would.
Yeah, the American ones just look a bit more evil than the English ones. Like, that's the best way to put it. Yeah. There's what a British robin looks like.
Look how fat he is.
So there might be an American person watching this right now that's like...
This isn't a bird book, it's a Christmas card.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, wow, you've been putting some right details in Jean-Claude.
There he is. Well, he's like the band, like, front man, so he has to look good.
He looks like he'd play, what do you call them, the little drums.
A tambourine.
No! Those are really artsy people who do poems, and they have a little pat drum.
Bongos?
Bongos! Who do you know that does, like, sad poetry while playing the bongos?
I don't know when I would watch them.
Oh, are you going straight in with a Posca pen?
Yeah, I'm going to try and make him a little bit smaller, though.
Are you trying to do it like a band poster so you've got him coming out?
I don't know what to call it. We'll have to think of like a band name as I'm going.
Oh, going great so far. Look, we've got our second member already. Can you remember Mr. Men? Every single earthworm in Mr. Men used to look like that.
It's not an earthworm.
Why has he got a big red crest?
He has on that one.
Are you sure? I think you're really putting this up for artistic interpretation now.
No.
So this is my bird that Adam picked out for me. And since he's called a cock of the rock, he is his rock.
He wants to rock. He's a very red bird.
Yeah. Oh, that's creating a fun texture on that side. What was that song that you used to sing to me about? Something about tropical birds. Wasn't it something like, my birds? You have no idea what I'm on about? No. The vulvic water one?
Oh, that was Tyrannosaurus Allen.
Didn't he talk about birds?
Yeah.
Your birds.
There we go.
My birds, your birds.
I thought reminding you of that would provide like a beautiful soundtrack for the video. Should put that in the background the whole time.
I'm the daddy now. Over there.
It literally does look like a band poster now.
Jean-Claude plays the triangle and she plays the tambourine.
Are we going to pick something she could do with a beak?
She cleans the hoover out for the band, according to you. She's just a groupie that cleans the hoover.
Are you excited to pick the next birds to draw?
Oh, I'm ecstatic. How many are we going to do?
I reckon you could pretty much only fit like one more in. Oh, there's some good ones on this page, guys.
Oh, no. And it's your turn to choose first as well for me. Oh, jeez. Oh no.
This one, it looks like his head's inside out. Oh, there's a flamingo in here.
Oh wow, an actual bird we know.
Yeah, I think I'm pretty set on giving you that guy.
Well, let me have a look. I haven't had a proper look at him yet.
His head looks like it's wrapped in bacon.
Well, that's King Condor. Which one of you put bacon on my face? Oh, look at that like scarf he's got on.
Oh yeah, he does. He has a really fluffy, like, cashmere scarf. This video's been very educational, Adam.
Well, if I've got to do King Condor, you can do Magnificent Frigate Bird.
The one with the big dewlap.
There he is in flight, and that's him when he's been stung by a bee.
Oh, he looks a bit cuter when he...
No, you have to do that one.
Oh.
He's like, I've eaten too much bread.
All of mine will have, like, an occurring red theme, at least.
Hmm. Come on.
No, I'm so excited to watch your artistic interpretation of this guy.
King Condor?
Yeah. Do you think he lives in a condo?
Yeah, King Condor's condos. That's why he spends all of his band money on. He's like a property, like...
Okay. And invests in good bacon.
Yeah. Pay me with bacon. I want to put it on my face. Okay, let's get...
Oh, I'm so excited. I'm putting off doing mine so I can watch what you're up to.
He's got like this... weird thing going on in his face, isn't he?
We need to turn this into like an official poster in our star.
Oh, jeez. I can't even make out like, exactly what his face is supposed to look like, so this is just guessing.
I think this is going to be one of the funniest things you've ever attempted to draw. I don't think you've named your pink bird yet.
That can be Patricia.
She does look like a Patricia, I'll give you that.
She looks like a sock puppet.
You should dress as this guy for Halloween.
Oh, wow.
I'm so glad we have this book as evidence that these things exist. Then again, it's really old-fashioned. Imagine if they were all just made up.
It's not like the photographs.
Everyone made it just a mess with everyone. Look at that magnificent sack thing he has. It's almost like a frog. You know, like frogs have those
things. Yeah.
You gotta add these like little sack spots.
Sack spots?
He's got them, look.
Okay.
It's a very important detail.
Oh, okay. I don't want to forget those.
He'd be very upset if you missed his sack spot.
The problem is that because his sack's so big, I can't put the rest of the bird in.
He looks really sort of embarrassed about it. It's like, I'm sorry, my sack's so big. What is that? That's got to have a scientific word.
Neck sack. I tell you what, when we decided we were going to do some cute tropical birds, I bet there's no colouring books that have this guy.
Look how magnificent I am. Colour me.
Maybe one day we should make like a colouring book with like really ugly tropical birds in it.
While you're colouring it, I'm going to try and read and see why it has a big sack in it.
Yeah, please do try explain this to me.
It doesn't say. How could you write a description about this bird with a huge sack on its face and not like talk my...
It's a fashion statement.
I tell you what, I know which bird's not going in the thumbnail.
I was concerned that my tropical birds didn't look tropical birdy enough, so I've just been quickly doodling in tons of like green foliage stuff, and I even written tropical birds, hoping that'll tie it together. But as you can see, Adam is on the floor. Yeah. And he's hiding whatever he's working on, so we're just waiting for this big reveal.
It's a surprise!
Yeah, things tend to be a surprise whenever you hide down there. Have you seen the mess of all the pens that we've put out?
I think we've used like every single one.
I wish it was easy to keep them in like rainbow order. It looks so much cuter when they're all in the proper colour order. Oh, it's nice to see you back.
I have returned.
You look mischievous.
Joe, it's a surprise. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Because the band, they've finally decided on a name.
Oh, this is brilliant news, yeah.
Do you want to see what the name is?
Okay. Jean-Luc and the Feather Frenzy. As if he really went to town with the font.
Jean-Luc did it.
Is he wearing a pink feather boa?
No, seriously, on the picture, that's what they have.
What's his name?
Jean-Luc, Patricia, and like...
What's a name that sounds like bacon?
Brian.
My uncle's called Brian. Oh, yeah.
Boris.
I like Boris. Yeah. Boris is
so good. Jean-Luc, Patricia and Boris, and together they are Jean-Luc and the Feather Frenzy.
What video can I link up here? What relates to this?
How about when you drawn birds in the first one?
Yeah, we mentioned our first video and we drew birds in it.
That'll be insightful,
at least I did.
Yeah,
that's an old video. Doodle did.
Your bird. My bird. Your bird.